Hello students, welcome to my class Physics in Your Life. Today we are continuing with our chapter Motion. This is the third part of our video. Myself Tushar Bharadwaj. So let's get started. Objectives: students will be able to define the terms distance and displacement. They will be able to distinguish between speed and velocity after the completion of this video. So first is distance. It is defined as the actual path covered by the object. Okay, so if this bike rider goes like this, okay, so the total path length of this road will be 200 meters according to this figure, right? So this actual path covered by the object will be our distance, and it is denoted by S, and its SI unit is meters. Okay, and it is a scalar quantity. It does not have any direction. Okay, it has only magnitude with them. Okay, students. So, and it, this is the symbol. Okay, I already told you. Okay, now next is displacement. It is the shortest path covered by the object. Now, if this bike rider wants to go from his home to the factory directly, so this distance is 120 meters. So basically, it is a shortcut. Okay. So this shortcut, this shortest path covered by this bike rider, considered as the displacement. Okay. So we can say that displacement is also called the shortcut taken by the bike rider. Okay, it is also denoted by S, but with this arrow. Okay, this arrow represents direction. So this is the symbol of displacement. Okay, and the SI unit is same meters, and it is also a vector quantity. Is it clear, students? So now, hope you understood the difference between distance and displacement. Okay. Similarly, we have speed and velocity, but we'll take speed and velocity later. Okay. So now this is the tabular form of the distinguish between distance and displacement. Distance is actual path covered. It cannot be zero. Okay. And it is a scalar quantity. Displacement, shortest path covered. It can be zero, because if the initial and final point will be the same, then the displacement will be zero automatically. Okay, and it is a vector quantity. These are the formulas of distance and displacement. Distance is equal to speed into time, and displacement is equal to velocity into time. Okay, now this is the symbol of velocity, and this is the symbol of speed. Okay, like this. Speed is defined as distance covered per unit time. Okay, so because speed is a scalar quantity, so here we are taking distance in the formula. Okay, speed is equal to distance upon time, and it is denoted by V, and its SI unit is meters per second. Is it clear, students? Okay, now if we provide direction to the speed. Okay, basically speed with direction is also known as velocity. Okay, it is defined as the displacement per unit time. Okay, because velocity is a vector quantity, so it has this direction arrow. Okay, so now this is the symbol of velocity, and this is the symbol of displacement. Okay, and this, its SI unit is same as our speed, meter per second, because meter per second, or it is a vector quantity. Okay, students. Now I hope you understood this small concept of distance, displacement, and speed and velocity. Okay, now let's have a look on the distinguish between speed and velocity. Speed is distance per unit time. It cannot be zero, because distance cannot be zero. Oh, sorry, it cannot be negative because distance cannot be negative. Okay, and it is a scalar quantity. Velocity, displacement per unit time, it can be negative. Okay, because direction can be opposite. Okay, and it is a vector quantity. These are the two formulas for speed and velocity. Okay, students, thank you.